Hello dear students, how are you all? Yes, which lesson we have started, can you guess? Yes, it is the heat. Yes, in the last video we have discussed about a heat. What is meant by the hot? What is meant by the cold? Yes or no? Then we have discussed about the temperature and also the thermometer. Today we are going to discuss them in a little bit detail. Okay, so thermometer. What is, first tell me, what is meant by the temperature? Temperature is nothing but a degree of hotness or a coldness is called as a temperature. An instrument used to measure, it is called as a thermometer. Okay, so what is meant by the thermometer? In Latin, thermo means heat. What is meant by thermo? Thermo means heat. Okay, meter, it is nothing but a measurement. To measure the heat, we use the instrument that is called as a thermometer. That instrument is called as a thermometer. Okay, then thermometer, there are mainly two types of thermometer, that is clinical thermometer and laboratory thermometer. There are two types of thermometer, clinical and laboratory thermometer. Laboratory thermometer is used in laboratory to calculate the chemicals, means to get the temperature of a particular chemicals. Are you getting? And clinical thermometer, which we are using in day-to-day life, this thermometer is also called as a doctor's thermometer. This thermometer is called as a doctor's thermometer. Now, the range. This is actually, the thermometer is made up of a very fine glass tube. It is made up of a fine glass tube in which, in between them, there is a capillary, fine capillary tube, which is filled with a mercury. And see, it is filled with a mercury, and mercury is a very toxic substance. Why there is only the mercury? Mercury is metal, am I right? It is a metal which is in the liquid state. Can you tell me why only the mercury is filled in the thermometer? Just recall why the mercury is filled in the thermometer. Why not any other components are filled in the thermometer? See, because there is a vast difference between its melting point and the boiling point. There is a large difference between its melting point and boiling point. So mercury is filled in the thermometer. We have to handle this thermometer very carefully. The thermometers which are there, we have to handle it very carefully, because once it breaks, if it will break from your hand, then mercury is a very toxic substance. So you have to handle it carefully. In a mercury, see, this capillary tube is, in the capillary tube there is a mercury which is filled in that. The construction of these two, of the clinical and laboratory thermometer, is same. These both are made up of a glass tube, in that there is one capillary tube which is filled with the mercury or an alcohol. Okay, then when this thermometer comes in a contact with a hot object, the expansion of a mercury starts. Means the mercury level rises up. This is how the thermometer works. But there is one main difference between the clinical and laboratory thermometer, that in the laboratory thermometer, the capillary tube is totally in a straightforward. But in a clinical, that is also called as a doctor's thermometer, here there is one bend. This bend is called as a key. This bend is called as a key. So what is the use of this key? See, when you are taking the laboratory thermometer, when you are using the laboratory thermometer, if you want to take the temperature of the particular substance, then we have to, when you are heating the particular substance, then you have to keep as it is laboratory thermometer, and then you have to note down the reading. But in a clinical thermometer, once it is kept in the mouth, and if you will remove from the mouth, the temperature remains same because of the key, and so that we can get the accurate reading of that clinical thermometer. Are you getting in? But when you remove, as soon as you remove from laboratory thermometer from the beaker while heating, the mercury level immediately falls down. The mercury level immediately falls down as it comes in a contact with the air. As it comes in a contact with air, the mercury level immediately falls. But in a clinical thermometer, there is one bend that is called as a key. Because of that, it prevents the mercury level to be falling down as soon as you will remove from the mouth. And we can get the exact reading. Now, the range of the clinical thermometer, if you will observe the clinical thermometer properly, then there are the two readings. Means there are the two scales on the both the side. That is, it is in Celsius as well as in Fahrenheit. While the laboratory thermometer, the range is -10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. -10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. While the range of the clinical thermometer starts from 0 degrees Celsius to 100 degrees Celsius, that is 32 degrees Fahrenheit to 212 degrees Fahrenheit. This is the range of clinical thermometer, and this is the range of the laboratory thermometer. In this, there is an important point of the key. The key is used to prevent the mercury level at that particular temperature. So as you remove, if you want to measure the temperature of a particular person, then when you keep in the mouth, or when you give in the mouth for the particular person, the level will not fall immediately when you will remove from the mouth because of the key. It prevents the mercury level from falling down. Are you getting? But in this case, in the laboratory thermometer, as soon as you will remove from the beaker, the mercury level will fall and you will not get the exact reading. So these are the two types of clinical and laboratory thermometer. There are some conversion, how to convert the Celsius into Fahrenheit into the Kelvin. There are some conversion that we will see in the next video. Now, one more point is that in a clinical thermometer, how you can take the precaution while handling the clinical thermometer. See, before using a clinical thermometer, you have to wash with the antiseptic solution. You have to wash that clinical thermometer with the antiseptic solution. And before giving to any patient or before checking for giving to the any person, you have to check the level of mercury. You have to check the level of mercury. It should be below 32 degrees Celsius. And if the level is more than it, then you have to give some small jerk. Means you have to give small jerk like this. Okay? So that it will fall the temperature. It will bring to the particular temperature. In this, the normal human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius or 98.6 degree Fahrenheit, 37 degree Celsius or 98.6 degree Fahrenheit. So this is the normal human body temperature. Are you getting this? Then you have to give, you have to check the level of the mercury. If the mercury level is not fixed, then you have to give some small jerk. After using the thermometer, clinical thermometer, again you have to wash with a antiseptic solution. So these are some precautions while handling the clinical thermometer. I hope you have understood this. Two types of thermometer. In the next video, we are going to see for the word problems of how to convert the Celsius into Fahrenheit and Fahrenheit into Celsius, then Celsius into Kelvin and Kelvin into Celsius. Thank you.